morning. We're excited about what you're going to show us this morning. We're excited about how we're going to experience you this morning. We're excited that we're standing. We're excited that our eyes open. We're excited that we're together. We're excited that your spirit is here. We're excited that you're dwelling in the midst of your people. We're excited, God, and we're anticipating a move on today like never before. We're anticipating for the sick to be made well. We're anticipating for the blind to see. We're anticipating for the depressed to be able to lift up their bowed down heads. God, we are waiting on you, Father. And your word declares that you would do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask or think. And we're thinking great things. We're believing great things. We're asking great things. We're longing for great things. Now blow our minds, God. Blow our minds in worship. Blow our minds in prayer. Blow our minds with your word. Blow our minds with the fellowship. Blow our minds with our relationships. Blow our minds on our job. Blow our minds in our school. Blow our minds in our family. Father God, do the impossible. Shift in this place, God. Move in this place, God. Have your way, 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 God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now, if you believe he'll do what he said he'll do, give God glory like you've never given it to him before. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah, God. God, you're worthy. God, you're mighty. God, we magnify you. God, we glorify you. Hallelujah, God. Oh, hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. How many of you know we serve a mighty God? How many of you know we serve a mighty God? We serve a mighty good God, Mark. We serve a mighty good God. And we're going to make that declaration this morning. Amen. So I want everybody clapping your hands, stomping your feet as we make this declaration together this morning. All right? I need everybody to do that with us. Come on, let's clap our hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Y'all know that. Timmy don't praise me. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Come on, let's sing it again. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Come on, we gonna call him holy this time. What a holy God we serve. What a holy God. Jesus. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a holy God we serve. Come on, what a holy God we serve. What a holy God we serve. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a holy God we serve. Come on, we love to clap. He's a righteous God. What a righteous God we serve. What a righteous God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a righteous God we serve. Come on, everybody, clap your hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. God, we bless you. We love you. We water.
Grandma used to love this song. She said it. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Come on, y'all know it. Sing along.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus.
Say it on.
Oh, tell me who can stand before us when we fall on that great day. Your name is Jesus, Jesus, blessed Jesus. We have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory.
Lord, help me, please. Got a screaming and shouting victory. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. That's it. Victory today is mine. I told. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy today.
Rose this morning, I didn't have no doubt, and I knew that the Lord would bring me out. So I fell to my knees, said, Lord, help me please. Got a screaming and shouting.
Come on, if you got victory, sing it like you mean it. Victory! Victory! Victory today!
I told get thee. We have the victory.
If you believe it, sing it.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Satan, you have to flee. Oh, tell me who can stand before us when we call on that grace. His name is Jesus. Jesus, bless him. Jesus, we have.
Come on, no music this time. Let's just declare it.
Name of Jesus, we have.
Come on, declare it like we mean it. In the name, in the name. Oh, woo.
Oh, tell me who can stand before us when we call on that great name. His name is Jesus, precious. Who can stand before?
watching. I'm sorry. We're going to say it one more time. Come on, let's say it, man. Oh, tell me who can stand before giants fall at the mentioning of his name. Demons tremble at the mentioning of his name. Sickness flees at the mentioning of his name. Jesus. Jesus. One more time, it feels real good. And come on, everybody, let's lift up. Oh,
when we call that great,
come on, let's just say Jesus, Jesus. Come on, keep saying Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, 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 precious, we have.
Got the victory, going to celebrate him for it right now. Going to celebrate him for it right now. Oh, that's it, that's it, that's it. Oh, that's it. Come on, come on, come on. You're the praise team. You're the praise team. You're the praise team. We have an audience number one. Jesus is his name. Jesus is his name. Jesus is his name, the one who was and is to come, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the only begotten Son of the Father, Jesus, our shepherd, Jesus, our high priest, Jesus, the sacrificial lamb, Jesus, the one who was hung, bled, and died for me, Jesus, the one who, being the joy set before endured the cross, yet for me, Jesus, the one who chose to leave his throne, to come to earth, to be beaten, battered, and abused, death for me, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is his name, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus, oh, there's something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus. Like the fragrance after the rain. Oh, Jesus, 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 let all heaven and earth proclaim. Will all pass away, but there's something about that name.
Come on, let's just, come on, just call on his name, just reflect on his name. The Bible declares that there's power in the name of Jesus. There's so much power in the name of Jesus
that your enemy don't even want you to mention his name to your problem, because your problems cease to exist when you mention his name. So your problems don't care if you do church. They don't care if you lift your hands, if you do your dance, but it don't want you to say, Jesus. I dare you to stare your problem right in the face and say, Jesus. Stare your uncertainty right in the face and say, Jesus. Stare your indecision right in the face and say, Jesus. Look at success that's coming your way and say, Jesus. Jesus, Father, we love you, Lord God. Jesus, we thank you. Walk in the room, Jesus. Walk in the midst of us, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. There's no sickness when Jesus shows up. There's no problem when Jesus shows up. As we prepare to transition, there's a passage of scripture where Jesus' disciples come to him and they're telling him, hey, you know, there's this guy, John, you kind of know him. And his disciples, they fast and they do all of these ritualistic things and it seems like they're pretty cool. And we don't do none of that. We haven't done any of those things for a while. Like, what's the problem? What's wrong? And Jesus says, I'm here. Jesus said, I'm here with you. John's disciples are fasting for my presence. They're praying for my presence. I am walking with you. And I hear the Lord say, I'm with you, even in this moment. Jesus is here. Jesus is here. JB, what are you saying? We shouldn't pray? No, that ain't what I'm saying. JB, what are you saying? We shouldn't fast? No, that ain't what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is we've been fasting and praying about some stuff. We've been fasting and praying about some situations. We've been fasting and praying about some decisions. And we felt as if we haven't heard God's response. And Jesus says, I am here. I am with you. We're in this thing together. I'm right here with you. So let's trust in him. Father, we trust in you. Jesus, we trust in you. We trust your leadership. We trust your governance. We trust your guidance. We thank you for the comforter you left. One who knows all things, sees all things, understands all things, knows the heart of your Father, and cares about us. And Holy Spirit, we ask you that you would reveal the mind of Christ to us in ways that we've never before imagined. Let the scripture come alive that this mind that is in Christ Jesus will also be in us. Let this be our reality, that the mind of Christ is the mind of every believer under the sound of my voice. Holy Spirit, transform. Renew our minds. Transform our minds into that of the Christ, so that we might think like him. We might believe like him. We might trust like him. We might reason like him. We might understand like him. And that from that understanding will our behavior be guided. And we will walk with the Father and see his kingdom come here on earth, even as it is in heaven. This is our prayer. Let it be done. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on and give God a big clap, big hand clap as our pastor comes forth. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Do you feel His presence? Can you feel His presence in the room? That's all we ask for, church. Nothing else matters. It's about you and Jesus. Nothing else matters. Nothing else matters. Thank you, God. I thank you for you being the praise team this morning, along with Minister JB. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise for him. And for yourself, come on, you were the praise team with him this morning. And we say thank you for that. We say thank you. Now, Heavenly Father, continue to be in the midst of us. Continue to transform lives and transform spirits in this place on today. Continue to, God, show yourself strong and show yourself mighty to us. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for giving us this day our daily bread. We thank you, oh God, that we came in this place one way, but we thank you we will leave out rejuvenated, renewed, filled with joy and vigor, ready to go on and face the world and do the work that you've called us to do. We realize when we're in here, oh God, we're getting refueled, but it's out there where we go to serve. So we thank you for the ability to serve. We thank you for the mind to come in here to get recharged and renewed and fellowship with other believers. Now, God, just continue to have your way in this worship experience. It's in the matchless name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. If you will turn with me to the book of Nehemiah. I'm just going to read one verse. Just going to read one verse. Nehemiah chapter 4. And I'm going to read verse 6. And that will be our scripture reading for this morning. I'm just going to read verse 6. So if you got Nehemiah chapter 4. Turn to verse 6. So we rebuilt the wall, and all the wall was joined together to half its height, for the people had a mind to work. Amen. Amen. Let us stand for our affirmation of faith. And I'll ask Brother Ronnie to come and welcome our guests. Let us stand. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. On the third day, he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. So great to see y'all this morning here at Mt. Olive on the Hill. Pray that you all had a blessed week. Amen. Amen. Thank you for taking some time out of your busy schedules to worship with us. We're so glad to have you. To our visitor friends, welcome. God bless you all. Hope that this week is better and more blessed than last week. You know, and at this time, if you would all please stand, and we're going to hug and love on each other. Amen. God bless you.
Thank you.
I'm so happy to see y'all this morning. I told Marcus and Javertis this morning, I said, well, the Lord just preached to me last night while I was in the kitchen. And so I said, doesn't matter. Not that I wasn't thinking about y'all, didn't care about y'all, but in that moment, I was like, you know, sometimes you just get a message and it's just for you. And I said, well, God, I just thank you for preaching to me this morning. I mean, that was last night. I thank you just for preaching for me last night. I don't know if this is what you want me to share with the people today, but I said, God, I thank you for giving me this word for me last night. So I had a good time and I called my stewards and I said, I'm not coming to church today. Y'all carry on. But none of them were in town either, so I had to show up. So I got my word. So I'm happy to say, I'm happy to see all of you here today. Amen. I'm happy to see all of you because my philosophy is not to focus on who's not here, but focus on who's here. Amen. So I am happy that you all pressed your way. And we pray for our families who are traveling. We know the Price family, we're going to congratulate Io when she get back. They won the championship. Keenan volleyball team, they won their championship. They were playing in Greenville last night, and then they went to Atlanta, to Georgia Tech, to Asante's basketball game. So we're just excited for what our children and our family are doing in the kingdom, because they are an extension of us. So when they go out and they do great things, then they are definitely a reflection of what is happening here. So I give God glory and honor and praise for that. Our internet keeps going in and out, so we will not play the announcements this morning. Mm-hmm. So that's why it keeps going back and forth. It is going in and out, so we're not going to worry about that. We're excited and we're celebrating what God is doing, and we're not giving any credence to anything else. So I'll just briefly tell you, the YPD, they're still collecting during their donations. The flyers are in the back, both of their donations. If you please make sure you adhere to that and bring them, y'all, next Sunday. We'll try to get out a message next Saturday night. So if you make sure your message go out Saturday night, so as people are getting ready for Sunday, they'll put their they're collecting dimes in a water bottle. And then we're collecting gently used shoes. Please bring your shoes in a bag. Don't just bring your shoes and drop them off. So we're collecting gently used shoes as well. And are there any women in here who are excited about Women's Day? Any women excited about Women's Day? I'm telling y'all, I'm so excited. So Women's Day is going to be in two phases this year. Because last year, Women's Day, or anytime we have a special occasion, we do not have adequate seating. So we're going to have part one that morning. And we do have special guests coming in from out of town, 10 o'clock. And Dr. Andrea Jones is going to be our preacher that morning. And they're bringing their praise team. And it's going to be awesome. So make sure you're back here on the fifth Sunday. All of them are coming. And then at 3 o'clock, we're going to go over to Adams Northeast AME Church. And our good friend, Reverend Adam China, is allowing us to use his facility free of cost. But y'all, we got to get there and we got to set up. And it will be Richland County Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Incorporated. So there's going to be about 200 of them. So I need all of us to show up. And then we'll have our sisterhood worship service. So we're inviting everybody, Greeks, Eastern Stars, Mason, whoever wants to come. We're inviting everybody to come out. And we want to pack Adams Northeast AME Church on that day, the fifth Sunday at 3 o'clock. Amen. So we've already started planning. Ladies, we have another conference call Wednesday evening. So look out for the email that will have the time and the phone number to dial in on this Wednesday for our call. I am excited to share one more piece of news with you before I share our guest with you this morning. On this past Wednesday, some of you may not have been here, but some of you were. But we had an exciting time at our quarterly conference with our elder, Presiding Elder Coleman. And on Wednesday, one of our very own was presented a license to preach. So please join me in welcoming Sister Lamoris Boyles. The elders already presented this to her, but I want to present it to her during the worship experience since all of you were not here. It says, African Methodist Episcopal Church licensed to preach. This is to certify that Lamoris Boyles has given evidence that God has called her to the preaching ministry. And she is licensed to preach the gospel in the African Methodist Episcopal Church, recommended by the Second Quarterly Conference under the jurisdiction of the Columbia District from Mount Olive African Methodist Episcopal Church, Columbia, South Carolina, given under my hand the 26th day of February, the year 2020, Reverend Roslyn G. Coleman, presiding elder. Y'all, that's a big deal. So we thank you, and you know that your church is definitely always behind you and supporting you on this journey. Word to the wise, get that copy, get it laminated, and then frame it. They will ask you for it again, so make sure you keep a copy of that. Amen. Bless the Lord. Many of you know when I stand up here and I preach or either give my words, I'm always saying something. I can't say if it's positive or negative, but I'm always saying something about school. Well, today, pleasantly surprised that our dean, the dean of the Dickerson Green Theological Seminary at Allen University, Dominique Clark, I'm messing it all up, Hopkins, Dr. Hopkins is here with his beautiful wife, Karen, this morning. So y'all give them a round of applause. And Dr. Hopkins, Dean Hopkins, is also an ordained itinerant elder in the African Methodist Episcopal Church. Now, they're from California, so, you know, is it cold to y'all this morning here in South? But I'm just grateful that the two of them have decided to come and worship with us at Mount Olive on the Hill. So before we go into our offering this morning, I would like to offer them a word to say, either, both.
Greetings. Joy in the name of Jesus. It's a blessing to be here. Mount Olive. Your pastor always said it was on the hill, and I said, is that part of the name? And so we drove up, and sure enough, it was on the hill. So it's truly a blessing, my wife and I, to be here at this great church. Bless your pastor. Your pastor is one of the shining stars at Dickerson Green Theological Seminary. So you're blessed to have her. That's right. Give God some praise for her. Give God some praise for your pastor. Yes. And so we said we were going to come, and we came, and we've been blessed thus far. And so we're looking for a great time in the Lord, and we're expecting to hear an amazing and a mighty word from the Lord. I feel the presence of the Lord in this place, and we're truly blessed to be here. We probably will be back. Amen. Amen. God bless
you. Forward to it. Thank you, Dr. Hopkins. We're definitely looking forward to it. Let us prepare to give. Let us stand. We'll prepare to give. You want to try one more time? I'm totally fine with your cutting it, Brandon. It's okay if you need to. Totally fine with that. Don't know if I know that text to give number off by heart. 610-4008. 610-4008. So this morning, as we prepare to give, you can give via Cash App. You can give online, MountOliveOnTheHill.com, or you can text Mount Olive AME to the number that you see on your screen. You can Cash App, you can text to give, or you know, you can also place your gift in the envelope. If you need an envelope, I think we do have more in the back. Do you have more? I have some back here. I'll get it in just a second. If you need an envelope, if you can lift your hand, we'll make sure you get one in the back. Okay, we'll make sure we get one to you. Okay. Mark, you want to lead us in our declaration this morning, our giving? Come on. Let's say it together.
God, I thank you for the seed, and the willingness to sow. I put it in the ground, and I'm loving the world. I said, Jesus is the presence.
Amen. 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 Let us all prepare our gift. No, you can go ahead. I'll give it to you. Everybody had a chance to give. You do great.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, God, we thank you. We thank you for the gifts that have been given for the further upbuilding of your kingdom. We thank you for those who gave, those who wanted to give, oh God, and those who gave cheerfully. Now we ask, as you've always done, continue to meet every need in this house and not just in this place called Mount Olive on the Hill, but meet the needs in our house. Come to our front door, oh God. Come inside and meet every need. We thank you and we praise you, oh God, because we know all things come of thee, oh Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Anybody ready for the word? Amen. I agree with Dr. Hopkins. I'm expecting to hear a great word from the Lord. And if he did it before, we know he'll do it again. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Now, if you notice, we don't have lyrics, but I still want y'all to be the praise team. So if you know it, just start singing on in. Get in where you fit in. All right? Hallelujah. I know, that's a lot of words. I know. Marcus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. But you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won. For you have never failed me yet. Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail me yet.
How many of you know he's never failed you? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord.
I know the night won't last.
If you know it, sing along. Your word will come.
Your word will come to me. My heart will sing your praise again.
My heart will sing your praise again.
Say, Jesus, you're still enough. Oh, oh.
Jesus, you're still enough.
Keep me within your love. Praise again.
Now the rest of this is simple. We're just making a declaration that your promise still stands. Yeah.
Your promise still stands.
Great
is your faith.
Great is your faithfulness, Lord.
Yeah.
Great is your faithful. Great is your faithful. Great is your. I'm still in your hand, Lord.
This is my confidence.
Come on, if that's your truth, just give God glory for that fact all alone. If he's never failed you, give God glory. That alone is worth giving him glory, right? Come on, everybody, let's clap our hands. Come on, come on. We're going to make this declaration, and we're going to prepare ourselves to receive the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, let's just prepare our hearts to receive the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. If he's never failed you, we're just going to go, and we're going to celebrate him until the word comes forth. Hallelujah. It's real simple. I'm going to do it, and I want y'all to do it, okay?
I see you move. You move the mountain, and I believe I'll see you do it again. You made a way when there was no way, and I believe I see.
Yo, y'all got it now. I see you move.
You move the mountain. Oh, I believe, and I'll see you do it.
I believe.
You believe you're going to see him do it again. Do it again, God. Do it again, God. Hallelujah. Come on, if you believe it, give him glory. Oh, God. God, we believe we're going to see you do it again, God. You're the same God. If you did it yesterday, you'll do it today. You're the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. Oh, promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. That you never fail me. Come on, everybody, one more time. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail me yet. I'm still in your hand. Let's say it again. I'm still in your hand, Lord. This is my confidence. That you've never failed me yet. Come on, listen to what you're saying. I'm still in your hand, Lord God. This is my confidence. If you did it before, you'll do it again, God. Still in your hand, Lord God. Never will forget, Lord. Never will forget, Lord God. Oh, God, yeah. Never failed me. You never failed me yet. Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Your faithfulness. Still in your hands, this is my confidence that you never fail me again. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, God.
Come on, give the Lord a hand. Come on, not me a hand. Not me a hand. Not Minister Gilbertus a hand. Come on, give the Lord a hand. Give the Lord a hand. Come on, praise him. Praise him, praise him, praise him. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, we say yes, Lord. We say yes, Lord. We thank you, God, that you have never failed us. We thank you, God, that you have never failed us. No matter what we've done wrong, God, you never leave us nor forsake us. We can come back to you over and over and over and over and over again. And you keep on accepting us. Your arms are always wide open. Always wide open. And we thank you, God. We apologize for all the wrong that we've done. But you keep opening your arms to us. And we say thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Now have your way in this moment. We know that you're no respecter of persons, and what you've done for one, you'll do for us all, God. So as you've spoken this word already, and I've seen it come alive, I thank you right now, God, for this preached moment, that your people will be encouraged, that their lives will not be the same, that they will be forever changed from what it is that you have to say to us. And as always, God, don't just allow us to be hearers of the word, but allow us to be change agents and go out and be doers of the word. This we ask in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Darth Vader. Lex Luthor. Megatron. Skeletor. The Joker. Luna Girl. Villains. We love to hate them. Villains. But if the truth be told, villains make for a good storyline. Imagine watching your favorite show and there's no villain. Imagine playing the video game and there's no villain. This weekend, we watched Wreck-It Ralph. Is that his name? We watched Wreck-It Ralph. Don't ask. Never heard of Wreck-It Ralph. But Wreck-It Ralph is a movie based on loosely on this video game. Many of you can relate to Donkey Kong. So it's an imaginary character, and the video game is called Fix-It Felix Jr. And in this video game, come to life, Wreck-It Ralph was always breaking things. Remember Donkey Kong video game? He was always breaking things. And Fix-It Felix was trying to fix everything that Wreck-It Ralph would break. And one day, Wreck-It Ralph said, I don't want to be a bad guy anymore. I want to win a medal. I want to be a good guy. I want to be the good guy. And so he went through all these things, and the way the movie was set up is at night when the arcades closed, the video game characters would travel through the cable cords, and they would go and intermingle and play in other video games. So they could go and play with Pac-Man and go and play in Candy Crush Land and all these things. And so there was a meeting one night of all the villains. It was almost like an AA meeting, and they were all sitting in a circle. And Wreck-It Ralph said, I don't want to do this anymore. And they said, you can't go turbo. You can't go turbo. You can't jump out of our video game and just go into another video game and be a good guy. You are a bad guy. This is who we were created to be. We serve a purpose. But he wasn't happy with that. He wanted to go and watch it. Google it. It's a neat little show. And so he got out, and the movie went on, and he was able to do some good, but he also realized, yeah, I do have a place. I want you to think about your life, and I want you to think about the villains, and I want you to think about what life would be like if they were not there. If the truth be told, they keep you on your knees. They help you develop your character. They help you to develop traits in you that probably lie dormant. You didn't even know they were in you. But when those villains come around, that pulls some things out of you that God is developing. So in this series, we're still in the series, and I'm very aware that we've transitioned over into Lenten season, but we've been in this series about 2 months now, and we're under construction. Under construction. So I was very clear in my instructions to God, like, okay, God, we're going into a different calendar season on a Christian calendar, but we are still under construction. Amen? So we're still under construction, and we're looking at leadership tips from the book of Nehemiah. So this morning, our text takes us to Nehemiah chapter 4. Nehemiah chapter 4. And I want you to look at verses 1 through 6 in Nehemiah chapter 4. Verses 1 through 6. And when you go to Nehemiah chapter 4 and you look at verse number 1, you've heard about them before, but we're going to see some villains. And the villains that we see in Nehemiah are named Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem. They came on the scene, I think, in chapter 2 when we were there, but now we're here in chapter 4, and it says verse 1, now when Sanballat heard that we were building the wall, he was angry and greatly enraged, and he mocked the Jews. He said in the presence of his associates and in the army of Samaria, what are these feeble Jews doing? Will they restore things? Will they sacrifice? Will they finish it in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heap of rubbish and burn ones at that? Tobiah the Ammonite was beside him, and he said, the stone wall they are building, any fox going up on it would break it down. Hear, O our God, for we are despised. Turn their taunt back on their own heads and give them over as plunder in a land of captivity. Do not cover their guilt and do not let their sin be blotted out from our sight. For they have hurled insults in the face of the builders. So we rebuilt the wall, and all the wall was joined together to half its height. For the people had a mind to work. For the people had a mind to work. This morning, church, I want to just us to think on the topic a made up mind. A made up mind. And I don't know if you're like me, but if you're like me, if someone tells you you can't do something, if someone tells you you can't do something, if you're like me, you really don't mince words or mix words, and you don't have a lot to say. But your whole purpose becomes showing them that you can do what they said you can't do. As my grandmother would say, I'll show you better than I can. Y'all had the same speaking grandma. Yeah, I can show you better than I can tell you. And so what's happening to this point in the book of Nehemiah is now Nehemiah is saying, we're doing this. We're building this wall. He's come there. He's helped the people. We've traveled from Nehemiah 1. Now we're up to 4. I told you last week, everybody minded their own business, right? Every family. In chapter 3, you see every single family coming together, taking their own little part of the gate. So this is the part in front of my house. This is the part in front of your space. This is the part. And they're all rebuilding. That's all we see. And actually, chapter 4, the first couple of verses in chapter 4, it has a special name, but the first couple of verses in chapter 4 of Nehemiah in the original Hebrew text was not in chapter 4. It was actually an extension of chapter 3. God, I don't know why you told me that last night, Lord, but now I know. I was like, nobody in church would care about that, but it's actually an extension of chapter 3. So when we were reading chapter 3 last week, these first couple of verses are an extension of chapter 3 if you're reading it in the original Hebrew. Now, back to our originally scheduled story. So now we're at verse 4, chapter 4. Villains are there. Villains are present. Whenever you try to do what it is that God has called you to do, and you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is what God is calling you to do, then you have to expect the antagonist. You have to expect the villains. You have to know that they are going to come. But listen to this. Our first point is antagonists, they serve a purpose. The villains, they serve a purpose. When I take you back to that movie Wreck-It Ralph, when Wreck-It Ralph left the video game, they had to shut the video game down because you couldn't have somebody constantly fixing something if there was nobody there tearing something down. And as we are under construction, we have to realize that even though the world that's out there may be tearing us down and beating us down, but every time that world makes us go on our knees, God is building something up in us. And so we're like, God, why are they giving me a hard time? Why are they doing this to me? But it's keeping you on your knees. If you never have to deal with conflict, you'll never know that you have the ability to deal with conflict. If you never had to deal with somebody smiling in your face and then stabbing you in your back, you never knew you could be so strong and hold your shoulders back and still hold your head up. Sometimes God put this stuff in your face. I used to hear people say in the old church, and I hated it when they said it, but they said trials come to make you strong. And I was like, I don't need that. I could just lift weights. I don't have to have trials to come in my life to make me strong. What are you doing? But if you're like me, you can admit that sometimes you have it too easy. And this part of the message may not have been for y'all, but I know what God was saying to me is that you got comfortable. Nobody was checking you. You were just in a nice, comfortable place. You were in an easy place. But now Let me build something in front of you. You're the silly girl that walks around and thinks that nobody dislikes you, that everybody likes you. Yeah, you're that naive. Let me show you that they don't. Let me put them right in front of your face and show you that they don't. And that's all these people did. They taunted the Jews. They taunted God's children. But it's so amazing that even though that opposition is there, God has still already told them, this is what you're going to do. You are going to build this wall. And so that's our encouragement. Even though the villains are there, even though the antagonists are there, we cannot grow weary in well-doing. We have to stay the course. You have to stay the course, no matter how long it takes. So the Bible tells us that Sanballat was there and he was angry. And not just angry, y'all. He was infuriated. I mean, he was not just like a little bit mad. He was mad. Like, he was really mad. But how does that work? How do you get so upset because somebody is helping someone else? That's all Nehemiah came to do. He was coming to help other people, his people. That's all he was doing. But you know, the enemy really don't want you out there helping other people. Do you know that the enemy don't? No, stay over here, stir up trouble, keep doing this, because stay in the enemy's playground. Don't go out and try to help somebody. And as soon as you go out and try to do what God is calling you to do, somebody's got the audacity to get mad. He was very mad. The Bible says that they started name calling. Really? So this just didn't start with your children or your grandchildren. They were name calling in the Bible, y'all. These feeble Jews. Look at these feeble Jews. What do they think they're doing? What do they think they're doing? And it's one thing, y'all, when you decide, I'm mad. But see, let me tell you, the street committee says misery loves. Okay, so Sanballat couldn't just be mad by himself. What fun is that? So he decides, you know, there's the three of them. There's the three of them. He decides to pull Gresham, and he decides to pull Tobiah into all of his madness. And they call them feeble. They're like, look at these feeble Jews. Will they restore things? Will they sacrifice? What do they think they do? They think they're going to finish this in a day? Like, really, who do they think they are? Has anybody ever said to you, like, who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Like, forget that Jesus died for you, that he suffered it for you, that he got up from the grave for you, that he said you now have all power in your hand, that he says greater is he that's in me than he that is in the world. But yeah, somebody said, who do you think you are? I'm a child of God. I'm a child of the Most High King. I am an anointed one. I am appointed. I am sent here to do the assignment, to do the work that God has called me to be. That's who I am. I don't have to think about it. Who do you think you are? I don't have to think about it. I know who I am and what I believe today. Unfortunately, it's too many of us don't know who we are. We don't know who we are in Christ. We don't know whose we are. So as soon as the enemy comes, like, look at feeble Lamora's. Look at feeble Arlene. Like, look at her. We just wither up and want to fall away. Because we don't know who we are. Oh, they hurt my feelings. They were talking about me. I didn't do anything wrong. Anybody else ever feel like you've been picked out to be picked on? Or is that just a country Georgia saying? He'll tell me it's a country Georgia saying. Okay, you've been picked out to be picked on? This is what was happening here. And not only did he do that, not only did Sanballat do this, the third verse tells us that Tobiah also was there. And Tobiah said to them, look at this wall that they're building. Any fox, if they go up on the wall, a little wall will break. Trying to break your confidence. Have you ever had somebody in a leadership position to try to break your confidence? To try to break your confidence? Because if I can break your confidence, basically the point is, number two, don't get distracted. If I could get you distracted, get you to think about what I say. I don't want you to think about what you're doing. I want you to think about what I'm saying about you. And God says, this is the work I want you to do. And the enemy is just taunting all around you and saying all these things and mocking you and calling your name. And you get distracted. You start looking around and looking at all the things that are going on around you. Focus on what God told you. Focus on the assignment that God gave to you. What was his assignment to you? Everybody had an assignment. Here, there's to rebuild the wall. But I want us to jump from the pages of Nehemiah, and I want to come to your street. What has God said to you? What has God said to you in your life? What specifically, you know beyond a shadow of a doubt, this is what God has called me. This is the season where God has called me. And while you're in that season, you're facing opposition. Leadership is opposing you. Your peers are opposing you. Even your subordinates are looking at you like you don't know what you're doing. Who is opposing you? Are they just serving as a distraction to keep you from focusing on the bigger picture? See, at God's pace, I told you, God is building leaders. That's what this whole thing with Nehemiah is about, helping us to build our leadership skills. And as a leader, I actually had somebody tell me this. I'm not going to quote it exactly right. As they were trying to get me to operate in my role and know who I am, I think the guy on the keyboard said to me, you're supposed to, you need to hear from God and cast vision and not get caught up and trying to complete all the tasks. Don't that sound like him? Because when you get caught up in trying to attend to every single detail, when do you have time to listen and hear from God to be able to say what the people are supposed to do? And didn't we say in Nehemiah? Nehemiah didn't say, I'm coming to rebuild the wall for you. God sent Nehemiah there to give leadership, to give governance, and it says, and we'll jump ahead, but the people had a mind to work. And Nehemiah showed the people how we're supposed to do this together, not Nehemiah. You just go and do everything, and we talked about that spirit, and I'm convicted of it. You just say, well, you know what? By the time I get you to do it for me, I can just, yeah, you got that same spirit. So, you know, it'll take me a long time to come in and rebuild this part, and rebuild this part, and rebuild this part, but the I can just do it myself spirit says, let's do that. And you think it's okay because you've completed the work. It took you 5 years, but you completed the work. But God is sitting there saying, I never told you to do that. I told you to write the vision, to speak the vision, and that everybody else was going to take care of their own thing. So you know what I'm doing now as a leader? I'm robbing you from developing something that God wants to place inside of you because I'm doing it for you. And we think we're helping people. It's called enabling. We think we're helping, and we're not helping them. And if they don't do it right, you know what? They need to be accountable. But when we do it for them, now I'm depriving you of your opportunity to grow. I was told last week that somebody was very upset because I preached about them and that I didn't need to call their names in my sermons anymore. So I'm not going to call any names right now. But in my house, I have to say, don't allow somebody else the opportunity to learn. If I say, what is 2 + 2, but I'm not talking to you, you can't say the answer. Because now I'm trying to develop something in somebody else. And some of us, we're just like, and we want to jump out and we want to say the answer and we want to do it all when I'm saying, God is saying, no, let me develop you and let me develop you and let me develop you. Let me develop everybody. And not just one person. Come and do it all. The whole point I'm trying to make, church, is you can't get distracted. Tobias, Sambalat, all they were doing is they were trying to distract them. If they were focused on what he was saying about the fox coming up on the wall and making it fall down, they would, oh, wait, let's go and fix this. The whole point wasn't for them to finish everything. At that point, they had only built the wall up about halfway. And they did have some cracks in the wall. There were some cracks in the wall. They weren't finished. But the enemy saw it and like, what do they think they're doing? They were moving at a very accelerated rate. That's what they were doing. And the enemy got scared. Did your mom and daddy ever tell you that sometimes the reason the person is bullying you is because they see something in you that they don't have in themselves and they're intimidated by that? Yeah, so they kept going on and on and on about, look at them, because they really did fear that they were going to do that thing, build it in a day. What are they doing? Do y'all remember how many days it took them to build it? I said that last week. Yeah, that's jumping ahead. But yes, the next thing that happened, so Sanballat is talking noise, Tobias is talking noise, and then Nehemiah does what I told you is fundamental for every leader. Don't call yourself a leader. This is not your foundation. He prayed. We started out with prayer. He prayed. He went back to God again. But y'all, Nehemiah prayed an interesting prayer now. This is a very interesting prayer. Very interesting prayer. And I have it. I want to read it to you. I want to read the prayer to you that he prayed. I know we read from the New Revised Standard earlier, but I want you to hear this prayer from the Message Bible. When he read that, when he said that, I thought, oh, Lord, this is a little different. But this is what he said. It sounds like some of the prayers y'all might pray. Nehemiah said, oh, listen to us, dear God. We're so despised. Boomerang their ridicule on their heads. Have their enemies cart them off as war trophies to a land of no return. Don't forgive their iniquity. Don't wipe away their sins. Don't, because they have insulted the builders. Wow. He's like, get them, God. Get them, God. Get them. Like, get them. This is what they're doing to us. Get them, God. The New Revised Standard. Hear, oh God, for we are despised. Turn their taunts back to their own head. But I like the way the Message said. He said, boomerang, because a lot of the kids now, they do that. Y'all know that app, boomerang, that y'all, no, just playing. You're not that younger than you. Boomerang. Y'all, or some of y'all know what a boomerang is. Okay, you don't know about the app boomerang, but when you throw the device, the boomerang, what happens when you throw it? It comes back to you. So Nehemiah is saying, God, everything that they're saying to us, bring it right back onto them. Boomerang that thing. That's a prayer. Because some of y'all go and pray the boomerang prayer. The boomerang prayer on your enemies. When you leave here today, go and pray the boomerang prayer. Lord, basically give them a taste of their own medicine. Give them a taste of their own medicine. It's nothing like tasting your own medicine. And some of y'all in my generation, your mind, when you heard Boomerang, went to 1992 and Eddie Murphy and the movie Boomerang. Yeah. I know what street you're on. You went right there. You went right there. And in that movie, you know, Eddie Murphy, what was his name in that? Marcus. His name was Marcus in the movie, huh? His name was Marcus. But he had this reputation, if you haven't seen it, as a ladies' man. Y'all shaking your head like y'all watch the same Netflix I watch. Okay. So he had this reputation. But then he got bit by his own medicine. He started falling head over heels for someone. And church, that's the way it works. I mean, you can call it boomerang, but I think there's another phrase we can use for called sowing and reaping. Is it not kind of like boomerang that? Okay, so you throw out insults and you throw out all this stuff and that's what you need to get back. But if we sow love and we sow joy and we sow peace, then that's what's going to come right back to us. So Nehemiah prayed, Lord, they're cocky. Lord, they're teasing. They're taunting us. Lord, this is what I want you to do. So after he prayed that prayer, as soon as he finished praying that prayer, it says we kept at it. We kept repairing and we kept rebuilding the wall. And then he goes on to say, for the people had a mind to work. And I believe that the people had a mind to work was God's response, God's way of responding to the prayer. Because it can get very discouraging when you're doing the right thing and people are always on your back when you're doing the right thing, and people are always giving you a hard time, even as a worker, that can be very, very, very discouraging. And so I believe that after Nehemiah prayed that prayer, God said, you know what? I hear you, Nehemiah. I hear you. And Mount Olive, he's saying the same thing to you today. He's saying, I hear you, Mount Olive. You're trying to do your thing. You're doing the work. And you know, you may be, however many of you are here are doing the work. You're like, okay, God, I'm doing too much. Somebody else need to help carry the load. And there are other ministries or there are other people and they're taunting and they're saying this or they're saying we're trying to do this or trying to do that. God, all we're trying to do is what you called us to do. We're not trying to operate in anybody else's lane. We're just trying to do what you've called us to do on your job and in your homes. And you're getting tired and you're getting weary and you're saying, Lord, I don't want to do this anymore. But then you don't even know it, but somebody praying for you. It's praying on your behalf, interceding on your behalf. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, you just get this energy and you're just like that little engine that could, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. I use a lot of children's books. I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. I wonder why. But you realize that now you're able to do what people said you couldn't do. You're able to be what people said you couldn't be because somebody was praying. Because you as a leader were praying, somebody else is able to walk the walk that God has called them to walk. Somebody else is able to have their character developed and be strengthened in the way because they've gotten so comfortable with somebody doing everything for them. But you're able to see now that God is doing exceeding abundantly more than you can ask or imagine because you have a mind to work. Church, God wants you to succeed. He didn't bring us this far to leave us. I want to say Marvin Sapp said it best when he said, you saw the best in me. Was that Marvin Sapp? Did I get that right? You saw the best in me when everyone else around saw the worst in me. And maybe I'm talking to the wrong crowd because maybe the people in here, people around you have always seen the best in you. And nobody's ever seen that other side. But can you say that there was a time in your life where you were at a low place? It's not, it may not be, but some of you, it may be where you are right now. Some of you, you can remember that time. And everybody who you thought should have been there helping you on your side, trying to help you along the way, they were nowhere to be found. They were nowhere to be found. They were hurling the insults. They were doing all these negative things. But God sent someone. But God sent someone. But God sent someone who could see something in you that you couldn't even see in yourself. See, Wreck-It Ralph had an esteem problem. He didn't know who he was. He didn't know his purpose. But when it was time for him to go back, Felix Jr. came and told him, Ralph, because you've left, they're getting ready to unplug our video game. They're getting ready to take it and haul it off. And all of our characters inside of the game will be homeless because you left. And we're sorry that we didn't treat you right. But this is just a role that you're playing. You are the bad guy, but we need you. Because if you're not there to do what you're supposed to do, None of us can do what we're supposed to do. And the whole video game gets shipped out. Maybe you're the villain. Maybe you've been the bad guy. God says he can turn it around. God can turn it around. God can turn it around. Maybe you're wondering why the villain was in your life. God, why do I have to have Sanballats and Tobias in my life? God said, because I have great things in store for you. And as soon as you make up your mind, as soon as you make up your mind that no Sanballat, no Tobiah, no Gresham, no Wreck-It Ralph, no Lex Luthor, no Darth Vader, no one is going to stop you from doing what I've called you to do, as soon as you make up your mind to be faithful to your assignment, then you'll be able to walk with confidence. Then you'll be able to hold your head up in the midst of opposition. Don't get weary, church. Don't get weary. Stay the course. Stay the course. God says greater. Greater is in store for you. Does anybody want greater today? Let us stand. Does anybody want greater today? Does anybody want to experience greater from the Lord? Does anybody say, God, yes, there's opposition around me. Yes, God, this job, Lord knows I can say this job is not what I thought it would be. But God, I know that you are developing something in me. God, I know that you are developing something and you're strengthening something in me. You're giving me what I need. For the next place in my life. For the next place in my life. But just like any good video game, if you can't master the first level, you can't go to the next level. Any video gamers in here? If you can't master the first level, you can't go to the next level. So God says, master this level. Don't ask me to move you from this point. Don't ask me to take you away from here. Master it. I'm putting something in you while you're on this level so that when I elevate you, you will say, oh, I learned while I was over there. I learned while I was over there. This is what I'm doing when I get in this situation. Anybody want to master it? Anybody want to master? The altar is open as we pray. The altar is open as we come to Christ. The altar is open as we commit to church. The altar is open. Does anyone ever than me want to say, God, help me master. God, help me master the level that I'm on. Help me master the level that I'm on. I invite you to come so we can go to the next level. Do it on my own, God. Anybody want to master the next level? Anybody want to master this level so we can get to the next level? So we can get to the next level? So we can get to the next level? Anybody want to go to the next level? Anybody need to go to the next level? Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for seeing the best in me when everybody else around me see the worst in me. I thank you, God. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. I thank you, God. For seeing the best in me. God says, I see the best in you, my daughter. I see the best in you. I see the best in you. There are so many great and marvelous things that God is doing in your life. And God, we thank you for that right now. God, we thank you for your ability right now. God, we thank you for Angel and everything that you have in store for her. Oh God, we thank you for every road that she will travel. We thank you, oh God, for every milestone, oh God, that she will overcome. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. Don't listen to the naysayers. Don't listen to the naysayers. Don't listen to the naysayers. Don't listen to them. Don't listen to them. Don't listen to them. Can you pray with me, church? Can you pray with me? Does anybody else need to stop listening to the naysayers? Stop listening to them. Stop listening to them. They mean you no good. They mean you no good. Doubt. Confusion. Frustration. Part of who you are. In the name of Jesus, it's not a part of who you are. In the name of Jesus, it's not a part of who you are. In the name of Jesus, it's not a part of who you are. God has so much more in store for you. But God said, I need to change your mind. I need to change your mind. I need to change your mind so that you have a mind to work. More opportunity. There's so many other things God said you can be doing that I have in store for you, but you know what? Truth be told, you're comfortable. You're like me, you're comfortable. Because you're real good right here. But God said the enemy, good is the enemy of great. So you're content because you're good, but God says, I want you to be great. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. Lord, I'm yours, Lord. I'm yours, Lord. Every day I'm yours, Lord. Ask him to continue to mold you and shape you. Mold you and shape you into the perfect woman that he will have you to be. And then don't worry about what anyone else has to say about it. Know that you are God's woman, walking in God's authority, in God's season, in God's timing. And know that God is going to do things in your life that other people said would never be done before. And once he does it, open your mouth and give him all the glory. Give him all the honor. Give him all. We can appear to be whole and have it all together. But he's saying it's almost there, it's almost there. But stay on the wheel, stay on the wheel, stay on the wheel, stay on the potter's wheel, stay on the wheel, stay on the wheel, stay on the wheel. Just a few more intricate details, just a few more things I need to iron out, just a few more bumps, just a few more things. But he said, stay the course, don't grow weary in well doing. In due season, you shall reap if you faint not. thank you for the assignment. God, we thank you for the assignment. We thank you for the anointing, oh God. We thank you for the lives that are impacted, Jesus. And now, God, we thank you for the agony. We thank you for the pain. We thank you, oh God, for what may even seem like the nails going in our hands and the thorn of crown on our head, oh God. But Lord, we thank you that it's for a greater good, oh God. The trials come to make us strong. God, we thank you for the antagonist. We thank you for the villain, because we thank you that you're building something in us, oh God. And what the enemy meant for evil, we thank you, God, that you're turning it around and you're working it out for its good. Thank you, God, that you're working it out for its good. Thank you, God, that you're working it out, that you're working it out, that you're working it out for his good. Reunite it, reunite it, reunite it, reunite it. That's all I hear is reunite it. It's gonna be great. It feels good. Reunite it. Reunited. God says, before there is a reunion, with the flesh, there needs to be a reunion with the spirit. Quest me like never before. Seek me like never before. You know about me. You know of me. You've been in church all your life. God says, now allow me to saturate your mind. Allow my spirit to totally take control of every part of your being. Give yourself away. Give yourself away to me. Give yourself away to me. Give yourself away to me. And I'll give it back to you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for deliverance. We thank you, God, that you are a deliverer. We thank you, God, that you are a deliverer. We thank you, God, that you are a way maker. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. He says, I got more. I have so much more for you. So much more than you desire, so much more than you're saying, so much more for you. I'm gonna help you do what you've asked me to do, but then I need you to know that it's not because of you, but it's because I have an assignment for you. You know that God has an assignment on your life. Hold your hands up. You know God has an assignment on your life. You know God wants to use you mightily in a mighty way. And it's why the enemy, just like Sambalat and Gresham and Tobiah, you have those enemies that just keeps taunting you and that's around you. And sometimes you get caught up with them and you become the bully as well. And God is saying, that's not like you. That's not who I've created you to be. I've called you to be an advocate. I've called you to stand up when other people are putting people down. I've called you to stand up for other people. I've called you to intercede for other people. I've called you to be the person at school who won't join in with other people teasing and bullying every people, but you're the one who's supposed to open your mouth and say that's not right. So much more he wants you to give yourself to him. Give yourself to him. Thank you, God. The first step is giving ourselves to you, God. So we give ourselves to you, oh God, and we thank you for mental clarity. We thank you, oh God, for clarity in sound, mind, speech, oh God. We thank you that you will reveal to us our purpose, who we are and who we are supposed to be and what we are supposed to do in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. I give myself away so that you can use me. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Nothing belongs to us, church. Nothing belongs to us. Nothing belongs to us, Brother Brandon. Brother Brandon, nothing belongs to us. I give myself my life. Nothing is my own. Hallelujah, God. Now, God, we thank you. We thank you for every person, whether they came to this altar or didn't come to this altar. We thank you for them, oh God. We thank you for this place called Mount Olive on the Hill. We thank you for what you're about to do, God. Thank you. You that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, are in love and charity with your neighbor, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take his holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God. If you will come, 18 and older, those of you 18 or older will come. I think I'll have enough. We'll do one. If you want to stand or you don't, I can come to you, Sister Beth. I'll come to you. I'll come to you. And then I'll just have the one table for the children. I'll serve them when I serve the musicians. Okay. Let us all say our general confession together. Almighty God, Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoing. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them with hearty repentance and true faith, Turn your heart unto us, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we shall at all times and in all places give thanks unto you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your holy name, evermore praising you and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord, Most High. We do not presume to come to this your table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs under your table. But you are the same Lord, whose property is to always have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by his death and washed through his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him than he in us. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who your tender mercies did give your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his oblation of himself, once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and sanctification for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in his holy gospel, command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father. We most humbly beseech you and grant that we, receiving these your creatures of bread and wine, according to your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night, when he was betrayed, he took the bread. And when he had given thanks and broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Likewise, after the supper, he took the cup, and he laid his hands upon all. When he had given thanks, he gave to them, saying, Drink all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you, for the many, for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance of me. Lord, I thank you for this bread, the body that represents your broken body. Lord, which you gave for our sins. Lord, I take, I consecrate this bread. In the same manner, Lord, the cup, the shed blood, which you shed, Lord God, for the remission of sins. Lord, we consecrate it, and we take and drink. And so, Lord, now I take the bread which is broken. I take and eat. And the cup, Lord, which was shed for the remission of sins, Lord, I take a drink. The body of the Lord Jesus Christ broken for you, take and eat. The blood of the Lord Jesus Christ shed for the remission of sins, take and drink. Thank you.
Shout it out one more time. I'm expecting